Action.
Alright, I'm gonna have some leftovers from yesterday. Then I'm going to upload a video which has been loading while I was asleep, and I'm going to promote it as well. One where I use my environment and more particularly a tree to do some training. And I'm gonna finish these search tags and promote it on Instagram and Facebook. And then maybe respond to some YouTube comments. Alright, so I haven't vlogged in a while, and if you want to catch some more vlogging content, then explore my playlist, the occasional vlogs. This one is probably gonna be not as smooth as some of the previous vlogs, because I'm just gonna record some behind the scenes stuff on my phone today, and then later I'm meeting up with a handful of people to record some Zendragon content. And I think I'll show some clips as well from the camera recording, so you get to watch some of the action as well. And that's about it. I'm going to finish uploading this video, promote it, and then relax for a bit before it's time to do Zendragon recordings. Also, I just listened to my own recording, and if you think my voice sounds a bit difficult to listen to, then it's partially because I just woke up, but also because I have a cold. So I hope you can live with that. Some in-screen elements, so a subscribe button, and then I'm going to pick a video.
Lang afstand, så han ikke kan komme til. Der er du ret igen, når en charco godt kan fungere. Det her, der kan du godt intimidere personen, når det kan være, at han tænker for.
This is a self-defense video about how to defend yourself in a confined environment where you've got gravity as an extra factor, because this is a staircase, and there's a lot of things to go over. So we'll try and talk about different concepts and things to keep in mind, and also we're gonna test a lot of stuff doing some different scenarios later on.
Action. Let's talk about how to get up from the ground in a fight. So there's this common one which is done a lot in combat sports.
I'm not sure if I'm executing it perfectly because I just recently learned it, but where you post one arm and then you switch
up. I actually prefer a different way, which you may have noticed in some of my sparring videos, which I learned from Krav Maga.
Which is, pick your forward position.
like this.
From this position.
Yeah, so that's capoeira, right?
Yes, it's capoeira. It's like end from El Dorado. It has the right on it like this. How?
Jeg beklager, men lad os lige huske skinnebensbeskytter.
Ja.
Action. Følg os lidt frem på,
ja.
Hvad vi kan gøre. Du kan godt gøre lidt hurtigere til der.
Nu er det. Jamen det. Ja.
Sådan noget der. Ja, det er sådan noget. Og så er det måske, hvis man laver sådan en, hvor man stikker den frem, forlænger den som et skud.
Ja.
Så er det,
ja, det er der, du gerne vil komme ind, ikke?
Jo.
Go! You
need to
take the
one down. Ja. Yeah. So again, definitely bad odds. Using the side, and the best way to block, if you want to block against blunt force, would be like this. But even when doing this, you need to step off and create an angle.
Nu.
So I'm a little bit nauseous right now and pretty damn exhausted. As you can see on the floor, there's the wooden guandao and there's weapons just splattered all over the place. There's also a sparring sai here and yeah, pretty much I'm pretty exhausted right now, and so is my friend Nicholas, and his phone just called, but he was recording, so it was nice enough not to take it. But I got a lot of behind the scenes footage today. We recorded something from my friend Damien, who has the channel Monkey Fist, check it out. And also my friend Espen
from the channel Ebby Monster was here, and he was doing the camera recordings. And yeah, the phone is still calling, but yeah, that's what happened. Did a self-defense video with lots of scenarios tested for defending yourself on the stairs. And we did a tutorial on how to get up, a technical get up, showing three different ways. And we did a lot of sparring as well. We did some weapon sparring. And we did a crazy 15 minute long MMA sparring session, which is probably why I'm feeling nauseous. And my friend Nicholas, he was towards the end, after the fight, he almost felt like he needed to puke. So, but it's been fun and no one's been injured. So thanks for watching. I don't know if this is the final recording in the vlog. We'll see.
Now it's morning, the day after, and yesterday after the final recording there, I just felt progressively worse. My girlfriend showed up a little bit later, but I was just feeling way too bad to do any more recordings. I had a severe headache, which I think may have been dehydration, but also I was feeling very nauseous and just completely weak. At one point I puked and I had to ask her to help me in the bathroom because I puked there. I had to help ask her to flush because I was just so wasted. No energy at all. I don't think I've ever felt that bad, at least not in a long time. And I think it may have been carb depletion because I wasn't really thinking much about what I ate yesterday. And when we got up after the recordings, I just drank a lot of water because I was dehydrated, as well as my friend Nicholas. We both did a lot of sparring in the sun and recordings, and I just ate a lot of spoonfuls of peanut butter because that was the easiest thing. But then later, as I was feeling worse, I started thinking about how peanut butter is mostly fats, and I don't think there's a lot of carbs in them, in it, I'm not sure. So I started googling like how the body responds to having no carbs. So my theory is that I burned all the carbs in my system, and it's also how I solved it. I ate just a little bit because it was difficult for me to eat much, but I ate just a bit of carbs and took a few hours rest, and then I was myself again. But it was a crazy experience because I kept walking around with my head like this because I felt like I didn't even have the energy to do this. So anyways, now I'm just gonna take some of the weapons, the sparring weapons, and bringing them down to the cellar. So that's about it. And I'll also just show you what the cellar looks like, where I keep a lot of the weapons in the apartment, and also where there's laundry facilities.
And I need to bring all of this with me down to the cellar. So there's the wooden guandao, which I got to use against a pair of sai, made of polypropylene material, also for sparring. And also against this, which looks like the real thing, like it might cut you, but it's somewhat safe for sparring because it's made of a solid plastic material and then it's been painted, the Dao broadsword. I also brought this up from the cellar, a bow staff, but I didn't get to use that for any recordings either. And not these bad boys either, which are nunchaku, made for sparring, or the foam covered baton, which can really hurt, but it's much better than sparring with a wooden stick, which I've tried once as well. It definitely left some marks. Yeah. And also I actually got another
nunchaku, which is not for sparring. It's wooden and with chain. I think maybe I can show it if I can find it. Yeah, this thing. This is a solid weapon. Like, if I needed one for self-defense, if there was an intruder coming into my house, then this dowel would not be useful, but this nunchaku definitely would be.
So this is what the basement looks like.
There's some laundry facilities, and there's a lot of mess, as you can see, including a ton of weapons. Some of them for sparring, like these polypropylene hook swords, which, if you've never seen these tested in action, then check out the weapon sparring playlist on this channel. And there's also these heavy axes, which I've also done a video with. And when I first moved into this apartment with my girlfriend, with the rooms upstairs and this area down here, the initial plan was to try and see if we could turn this thing into a small training area for yoga and martial arts, perhaps for Project Medgang, so we can offer some more free training for people who can't afford it or don't have the opportunities. But that hasn't happened, partially because there's not the best air to breathe in and breathe out in this room, and also because we just need a lot of storage space. So before I finish this vlog, there's just one final thing I'll mention, which is a bit of a surprise. I'll just show two pictures.